One thing that's useful when trying to read in a language is recognising prefixes. So we're going to talk about a few of those in Italian today. Before we bring up any examples, what I'm going to say does not apply in every case when we see these letters, but it can be used as a tool to help you understand. Okay, so in English we have the prefix DE, which might, for example, negate or reverse the meaning of a word. Italian has a similar prefix, DIS. So, the verb fare, which I'm sure you know is to do, disfare is to undo, the opposite. Agio is ease, as in to be at ease, whereas disagio is to be ill at ease. Next, you may also have noticed that a lot of Italian words begin with an S. It was one of the things I noticed straight away when I started learning it. It felt odd how many verbs there were beginning with S. Well, that S can have a similar effect to DIS, which I think is why there are so many. But don't forget, it doesn't apply to everyone. So, vantaggio is an advantage and svantaggio is a disadvantage. Bollire is to boil, and spolire is to cool or to stop boiling. But then we have vuotare and svuotare, which both mean to empty. I believe the latter is more common these days. As I said before, this is just a tool, not an exact science. The S can also give you a clue in another way. There are words in Italian where if you take the S off and replace it with an E, you have something close to the English equivalent. So, sperimentare, to experiment, and stabilimento, an establishment. RI in Italian is like RI in English, to do something again. Dare, to give, and ridare, to give back. But once again, there are false friends here. Uscire, to go out, and riuscire, to be able to or to succeed. And then we have tornare and ritornare, to come back again. But as I understand it, these are often used interchangeably. Of course, there are some other words which have multiple options. For example, cambiare, to change, scambiare, to exchange, and ricambiare, to return or to reciprocate. Learning what these prefixes might mean can help a lot with making content more comprehensible. So, maybe hold off with that dictionary and study the words you don't know a little more closely to see if you can glean the meaning before you resort to looking them up.